What's going on, everybody? Riot's here, and I probably just peaked the audio when saying, yo, I'm very excited right now. My buddy Froggy Man Crisco just sent me this info on Atlas, this game that just was presented at the Game Awards, apparently, and it looks absolutely insane. It's by the makers of ARK. It's essentially ARK 2 for the most part, because, and I quote, we took everything that we loved about ARK and put it in the largest game world ever for an action-based MMO. We're gonna get into some gameplay and stuff like that in a second. This is very freaking exciting. I'll get excited easily. I may act excited easily, but this is authentic excitement right here. I'm pretty much dead inside, but the creatures and the combat they're showing off in this is crazy. So make sure to leave a like on the video if you guys are excited and want more news on this game as it's produced, even though I'm pretty sure it comes out this month. Be very stupid not to have it come out this month, although they should have been advertising it a little more. But, I mean, I've heard of it a few times. I hear about it a lot, actually, on Twitter. Had no idea it was this crazy, though. Alright, let me just read this little part, because it's important, and then we'll get into the gameplay. Alright, Studio Wildcard, the creator of survival poster ARK Child ARK reversed it. Survival Evolved is making a pirate-themed sandbox MMO where you can capture and govern entire islands, build and sail galleons, and then fight in massive sea battles against other players. It's EVE Online's Mashed with ARK, and it's releasing on Early Access on December 13th for $30. Dude, that is, like, not that, that's like next week, holy hell. Atlas was just announced live on stage at the Game Awards, but I first got the chance to visit Studio Wildcard earlier this month and experience it firsthand. We took everything that we loved about ARK and put it in the largest game world, oh yeah, that's what I just said. Studio Wildcard co-founder Jesse Rapzik tells me, did I say that name right? Oh god. We're sitting in the conference room at Studio Wildcard's Seattle office, debriefing after an explosive fleet battle that ended when the last enemy player accidentally loosed a fire arrow at his own fleet and burned to death. God damn. It's then that Rapsic says that's something I did not expect. We built some new technology that stitches together a world that's 1,200 times the size of a single ARK server. Holy crap, dude. That's crazy. That's Atlas at its simplest, a pirate-themed successor to ARK stretched over a massive swathe of ocean home to hundreds of islands, but Atlas' ambitions far exceed anything ARK tried to achieve. For one, it's truly an MMO where thousands of players can exist in one space together, and I mean together, in the EVE Online sense of the word, where everyone plays on one server, which with that sounds crazy. Are you sure about that? Are you sure you want to be the ones to go for this? I mean, I love you, Studio Wildcard. You've kept me entertained longer than almost any company has, aside from a few. But that's a lot to handle, dude. I mean, a lot of your servers currently have issues, and you want to go ahead and attempt to populate the biggest servers in the entire world? That just seems a little ambitious, I feel like. Atlas will only have one PvP and one PvE server for each major region. Oh my god. So players won't be arbitrarily segregated across hundreds of identical servers as in World of Warcraft. Dude, it's 1 AM right now. And I don't know the words to come up with for that. That sounds like goddamn insane anarchy. And either amazing or so painfully toxic. With just two choices of server to choose from, Rapsic is hoping that Atlas PvP server will eventually mirror the schmoshmobo of political scheming and bloody warfare that makes EVE Online so fascinating. We really expect people to take advantage of the large size of the world to stake their claim on parts of the map, establish a government, and build ships and outposts. See, that actually does sound insanely fun right there. Me and my subscribers, you know, Riot Brigade, dude, we'll just control our own little region. That sounds so freaking cool. But, god damn, is there a bunch of risks, oh my god. But unlike EVE, you won't need to wrestle with an arcane user interface just to play it all. For all that Atlas does, it's still deeply rooted in the first-person survival experience of ARK. That means chopping trees, taming wildlife, and managing basic systems like thirst and hunger while out at sea. That'll undoubtedly disappoint those who already don't like ARK. I was always indifferent to it, but once I took to the helm of Brigantine, I didn't mind those similarities nearly as much. Alright, a little more to read. I'm learning a lot about the game. I'm sure we all are right now. And then we'll get into the gameplay. I'm eager as well. I only saw like 5 seconds. Atlas's simulation of life aboard a ship is about as enthusiastic as it gets while still being fun. Similarly to Sea of Thieves, I think we all saw that one coming. Atlas finds joy in emulating the little tasks that make a ship actually sail. Players can personally man cannons, unfurl and turn sails, or patch holes in their ship. So just like Sea of Thieves. On bigger ships, you'll need a coordinated team to manage everything, just like Sea of Thieves. I guess just like real-life big ships, though, for the most part. But Atlas will also let players hire NPC crew members to boss around. That's dope. A big part of the game is recruiting crew and keeping them paid and fed so you can actually drive these ships around. And we've got a bunch of cool systems in the game for simplifying controls to your shipmates. Suppose that's pretty goddamn cool. Oh my god, there's a lot more to read. You guys might just want to steal a couple minutes in if you want to go right for the gameplay, to be honest. But, I mean, this is all pretty important stuff. Like, it's like getting into the monsters and the bosses and stuff. Our battle at sea was particularly cool because of the level of black magic trickery going on behind the scenes to make Atlas work as a single server MMO. Its entire world is more like 1,000 different ARK servers stitched together on a grid spanning several biomes that range from the frozen Arctic wastes to white sand Mediterranean beaches. Each grid contains a few individual handcrafted islands, and when you sail away from those to another grid or a different island, you are also seamlessly transferring to a different server node. It's a setup similar to- ooh, I like that. That's cool. Loading into a new world without necessarily noticing you are. The end result is an enormous map that I imagine will be more than big enough to house the 50,000 players Atlas can support at one time if they're all spread out. That spells disaster. I just skipped right to the monster part now. Hear me, monsters! When players first start a new character, they'll spawn into one of a few free port towns that'll double as a safe zone so they can learn the ropes and build a ship without immediately being blown up. Make no mistake though, Atlas is a sandbox MMO in the true sense that there is a little in the way of a linear story that players must follow. I kinda like that, but I don't care. No, I suppose I wouldn't want a new campaign anyways unless you get a bunch of like points or level up or something cool. A pet? A dog? Give me a goddamn dog. Wildcard Studio co-founder Jeremy tells me that there's a main quest that involves traveling the entire scope of the world to collect 9 artifacts and bringing them to the center of the map where players can fight an enormous sea demon aboard their ships. Just don't expect to roll into villages and see a dozen gold check marks adorning the heads of its residents. We're going to beat Blizzard in terms of making content. We're not the kings of making content, but I'd rather focus on our capabilities on building systems. Alright, so that was weird, just kind of get all competitive at the end, unless I misread it. Sounds a lot, it's just ARK too, dude. It's just ARK on a boat. ARK is pirates, I'm down, you know? Like, collect the artifacts, face the giant boss, all sounds kind of familiar. I can't freaking wait to play the crap out of this. I am so happy we're coming up on 30k on Twitch, because now I'm just going to be able to play it like 12 hours a day, dude. It's going to be awesome. Alright, gameplay time. Alright, now since I showed this at the beginning, now we're just going to be going through it, you know what I'm saying, dissecting it and such. Pausing it a lot, like just watch the beginning of the video if you want to see it without me being annoying. But like it's literally just ARK, like it's exact ARK characters, it's exact ARK cities and everything. Those people just got hung, obviously, but it's god. The ocean isn't as pretty as Sea of Thieves, looks like there's just going to be some thick competition going on around here, cause... I mean, in a pirate-based game, half the battle is the ocean. I mean, Subnautica has some pretty sexy water too, but it's not multiplayer. But I don't know, really, yeah, gotta be up on your freaking, up on your water, that's not good. But, I feel like this has more monsters. And giant servers with countries you could take over. See, that's where it gets crazy, dude, and this looks so freaking epic. Leave a like if you guys are excited for this. It's goddamn a mountain giant troll and some sort of electric shooting hydra, but the coolest part is they're fighting it with cannons and arrows and stuff, and not standing there with wands. I'm so tired of killing creatures with magic. No. Look at that thing, dude. That's awesome! And if you look in the distance, there appears to be what looks like either elephants or mammoths. I'm assuming they're elephants because I don't think there's... Yeah, there's a giant elephant statue in the distance as well. Some sort of Hindu god, I would imagine. But the fact that there's a giant, spiky-headed hammerhead in there is awesome. Because that means there's no basis for reality. Just monsters, dude. That's amazing. That's not as cool as the whale. Whale is awesome. That's pretty dope, dude. Oh, fist fights! Woo! This looks insane. He's got a scuba suit. There's the end game boss right there. Oh my god. This game is so much to take in right now. It's just way too freaking amazing. Just get a look at this freaking endgame boss though. So it's a giant kraken that essentially has freaking whirlpool tornadoes coming up. Looks like there's multiple ships. It's gonna take a full on fleet to take that bad boy down. I'm so excited, dude. So excited. Man, so there it is, ladies and gentlemen. Also, make sure to, I guess if this just hits like 2,000 likes, something small, I'll definitely do a giveaway where we give away a few free copies, because I honestly just also want some subscribers to be on my team, you know what I'm saying? All the subscribers possible, I join the Riot Brigade. I'll be in Discord with you guys chatting, you know, whatever we gotta do to have loyalty among the crew, because I wanna dominate and hurt people, and I feel like we could do that together. So yeah, leave a like if you guys want more info as this updates, because I'm sure they're gonna release more stuff on the bosses before it drops, and I'll see you beautiful people later.